Item number, SCP-037. Object class, Euclid. Special containment procedures. SCP-037 is magnetically contained in a subterranean complex, known as Site-22. Object size, spectral signature, and temperature are constantly monitored both on-site and remotely from Site-98. The primary containment chamber is lined with heat-conducting, radiation-resistant, nanopeak GFV polymer tiles, and evacuated of any atmosphere. Heat from the object is radiated into the surrounding rock. Should enclosure integrity become compromised, the emergency system will generate a low-power argon plasma shield. This is projected to provide a minimum of 4 hours for our on-site engineers to effect necessary repairs before the object breaches containment. In the contingency that stellar evolution proceeds ahead of projections and a nova event appears imminent, or if containment failure is otherwise unavoidable, any remaining project staff are authorized to initiate the PITWAC protocol. Description: SCP-037 appears to be a star, approximately 5 centimeters or 2 inches in diameter, with a luminosity of about 1 to the power of 10 to 12 times that of our Sun, and a surface temperature of about 5,000 Kelvin, determined by UBVRI analysis. The origin of SCP-037 is unknown. However, analysis suggests that it shares many properties in common with a typical main-sequence star, other than its anomalously small size. It is theorized to have entered the Earth's magnetosphere via the North Magnetic Pole. The object was discovered in 19... above the Beaufort Sea at approximately the North Magnetic Pole. Intense electromagnetic interference was reported by Canadian Forces Station, CFS, alert, followed by an extremely bright object descending towards the ocean from the sky. The SCPS Guardian responded and discovered the object wavering in an erratic trajectory about 200 meters above the surface of the water. Once containment procedures were devised, it was transported to Site-32 for study. Containment and transport of SCP-037 have been achieved by the use of powerful electromagnets to which the artifact aligns itself according to its own magnetic field. The primary challenge to containment thus far has been its powerful electromagnetic emissions, which are intense enough to be easily seen by the naked eye from high Earth orbit. Its current enclosure is located deep underground to prevent detection and to facilitate radiative cooling into the surrounding bedrock. In effect, the entire facility and the surrounding volume of the Earth's crust act as a massive heat sink. Addendum A. Over the past years of study, the star has undergone a shift and emitted EM radiation, suggesting that it is undergoing stellar evolution at a vastly accelerated rate. If standard stellar models hold up, this will soon result in an increase in radius by a factor of 100 to 300 times, and a concomitant increase in radiated energy. Emergency containment contingencies are being studied for that eventuality. Further progression of the star's life cycle will likely terminate in a stellar nova, which is estimated to have a yield of... Extrapolations predict this to occur and... Research is underway for a method to arrest this development or to transport SCP-037 a safe distance from the planet before it occurs. Item number, SCP-094. Object class, Keter. Special containment procedures. Since SCP-094 is apparently immovable, a research and containment facility has been built around its location, in the guise of an Argentinian military research base. No unauthorized persons or aircraft may come within 1 kilometer of the site, enforced by joint SCP and Argentinian forces. SCP-094 itself is enclosed in a gas-permeable steel-reinforced plexiglass cube, 3 meters on a side, with a single door, also of reinforced plexiglass, in one side. This door must remain locked at all times, except with O5 authorization under tightly controlled conditions. This cube is to be kept in the center of a 20-meter by 20-meter room, accessible with level 4 authorization. All personnel must secure themselves to tethers anchored to the walls before stepping onto the floor of the room. Security personnel are to be armed with tranquilizer guns, in addition to standard armaments. Description: SCP-094 appears to be a perfectly black sphere, 163 centimeters in diameter, suspended approximately 3 meters off the ground with no apparent means of support. SCP-094 has been classified as a miniature event horizon. Any matter that moves into SCP-094, including light, is irretrievably gone. However, SCP-094 is not a black hole, since it does not exert a gravitational pull. SCP-094 has been known to occasionally emit a number of different sounds, including ambient sounds of nature, static buzzing, and sometimes, human speech. No attempts to communicate with SCP-094 have yet succeeded. It is unknown whether these sounds come from SCP-094 itself, from something or things inside of SCP-094, or from some area that connects through SCP-094. A small percentage of persons appear to be drawn to SCP-094 because of the sounds it emanates. SCP-094 was discovered in 1920 in the Chubut province of southern Argentina, and at the time, was estimated to be 20 to 25 centimeters in diameter. Analysis of historical records indicates that the diameter of SCP-094 doubles in size, approximately every 31 years. Primary research activities on SCP-094 are concentrated on finding how to stop or reverse its growth without inducing cataclysmic failure. Addendum. The hand on SCP-1032, designated SCP-1032-15, will achieve its midnight event on 9/4/2690, approximately the same date as SCP-094 will fully engulf the Earth at its current rate of expansion. Note: a few millimeters a month may not seem like much, and no, at the moment you cannot see SCP-094 change day to day, but if it continues its exponential growth, in less than 250 years it will be a kilometer wide, including vertically. And that is assuming it does not grow even faster, which is an assumption that almost no one here makes. Dr. Llewellyn Garcia. Item Number: SCP-123. Object Class: Euclid. Special Containment Procedures: SCP-123 is to be held in a secured facility and is to be securely fastened to the top of a sturdy table by use of straps, chains, a net, or similar device. Absolutely no hooks shall be fastened to the device. The object and table should be centrally located in a room no smaller than 5 meters by 5 meters by 5 meters. No sensitive measuring devices should be used within 100 meters of SCP-123, as their measurements will be noticeably affected. More significantly, absolutely no objects should be inserted into SCP-123 except under experimental conditions. Transfer of SCP-123 shall be made with care, and effort made to prevent the object from being shaken or jerked with notable force. SCP-123 shall not, under any circumstances, be transported over large bodies of water by any method. No personnel below Level 2 must be allowed in the containment chamber with SCP-123. Any person interacting with the object should wear tight-fitting clothing that has absolutely no straps, laces, or other dangling components. Persons with long hair shall be requested to tie their hair back or wear a hairnet. Description: Object is a gray geodesic sphere, 65 centimeters in diameter, consisting of 60 triangles. The areas between these triangles are empty, allowing the center of the sphere to be seen. The material the sphere is composed of is unknown, and upon the recommendation of Dr. Research into the material composition shall be limited to visual observation until further notice. SCP-123 appears to weigh about 3.62 kilograms, though its actual mass is believed to be much higher. The geodesic sphere is hollow, save for the very center. At the center of SCP-123 is what appears to be a black sphere, approximately 1 millimeter in diameter. No light can be seen being reflected off or emitted from the black sphere. The core also appears to exhibit significant gravitational force, which massively increases within the confines of the outer geodesic sphere. This gravitational force can be measured using sensitive instruments several dozen meters away. Within approximately 3 meters, the gravitational pull is apparent to any observer, with dangling objects beginning to be pulled towards the sphere. At the surface of the outer sphere, the gravitational pull doubles the weight of any object placed onto the structure. The inner sphere's qualities are apparent when any small object is inserted within the outer sphere. Any such object quickly accelerates into the object and disappears. Any liquid poured into the object also is sucked into the central sphere. Analysis has shown that light that nears the black sphere is curved towards the center. The amount of gravity exhibited by the inner sphere at its surface suggests that its mass is approximately 1,029 kilograms, though the obvious gravity-reducing effect within the outer sphere means that its actual mass may actually far exceed even that. Note that such a mass would ordinarily imply a Schwarzschild radius in the order of 200 meters, way in excess of the approximate 0.5 millimeters actually observed, which can be considered further testament to the outer sphere's gravity-dampening qualities. Gases are affected by the gravity of SCP-123, and the atmosphere pressure at its surface has been measured at 205 kilopascals. However, gases are unable to penetrate the area between the triangles of the outer geodesic sphere. The reason for this is currently unknown, and is currently being studied. It should be noted that the outer sphere and inner sphere appear to act as one. Whenever the outer sphere is moved, the inner sphere follows. Further research is suggested into the nature of this relationship. Addendum: SCP-123-A. SCP-123 has been suggested as a disposal unit. The researcher currently in charge of SCP-123, Dr. is concerned about the structural integrity of the geodesic sphere. All requests for disposal must go through Dr. or request a formal hearing with Level 4 personnel. Until further notice, all interaction with SCP-123 is to be restricted to experimentation. Command personnel agree that further research is needed to understand the durability of the outer sphere. Lesson complete. To continue with your orientation training, subscribe to SCP Orientation right now, and make sure you don't miss any of our upcoming videos.